meetings, meetings, meetings. You probably spend so much time in them. And there's this new movement called asynchronous collaboration, which is becoming a lot more popular with remote workers. A lot of people are deciding to stay at home and work, and I don't blame them. It can be pretty stressful having to commute every day, and there's a lot of sort of upheaval on your day. Now, I wanted to suggest some no meeting tools that you can use at home with you and your team if you're looking to reduce or maybe even eliminate the meetings that you have in a given week. So I've picked out 7 applications which are quite popular on the market. There is a blog post to this below if you do want to read that as well. Welcome, my name's Francesco. We run Keep Productive, which dives into plenty of productivity apps and tools. So we'd honestly love you to have you as a subscriber. So do go down there and hit the subscription button. And if you do enjoy this video, like it as well. So the first one on the list is one that I've actually been using for about 4 or 5 years now, and it's called Twist. The application is very similar in structure to Slack, but it tries to approach it in a different fashion. It starts with threads versus sort of channels of communication that just on endlessly focused on chat and sort of conversation. Threads are more focused around more structured work, I guess. So for example, you wanted to start a thread on a specific video we're editing like this one, we could, and it makes that thread more intentional and more clear. And as well with asynchronous collaboration, it really does help me and Steve, who's probably editing this right now as we speak. We don't have any meetings apart from every 2 weeks where we get to do it together to do some filming and play a little bit of FIFA. But Twist is one of those apps that helps you to be a bit more intentional about how you're focusing on work. And it really does help you to stay clear on what the focus is. You can still do DM, private messaging on there, but it's an application that is trying to be more intentional at how you use it. For example, a good example of this is a notifications ability, where you can actually notify specific people without having to nudge everyone else in the conversations and sort of constantly keep updated with it. So next up, number 2 is Slack. Now, Slack's been around for a while and it is a way to reduce meetings. They've actually added a brand new video clip ability. And this is something that I think is massive for asynchronous communication and remote work, is being able to record stuff on your own time. It's a little bit like really slow version of tennis, the way that I see it. You record something and send it over and wait for their reply and be able to get that back. But the videos, I think, help paint a picture that's bigger than just what you're typing on the screen. So you can do that natively inside of Slack. We actually have a video on how to do it in the link in description. However, Slack's new introduction of that is definitely heading towards no meetings, which I think is a really good philosophy. They do have the ability to do threads like Twisters, but not in the same fashion, in my opinion, although that is something that you can do. So next up is Yak. Yak is an application which really is very similar to CloudApp, which is our next app on this list. But Yak allows you to record your screen and even send a voice memo. But what's nice about Yak is it transcribes it in real time, a very accurate transcription as well. It's also got a great ability that reduces the background sound as well. So that, for example, if you're in a coffee shop and you record something, then that's really effective. It gets across really easily without having to necessarily shout or go above the noise. And what I liked about it is I actually tested the feature when I was next to my washing machine, which was really loud, and it actually worked really well. And I don't know, sometimes you don't expect it to work well, but at the same time, it does do a good job at that. And you can also create channels and conversations inside of Yak as well. So it does have a sort of ecosystem platform built in. So number 4 is CloudApp. Now, I used CloudApp before, I think before Loom, which is our next app. Stop doing this, Francesco. So basically, CloudApp allows you to record videos or what's on your screen, even GIFs as well. And it's nice because you can send them over to somebody. And what I like about it is if you have the Mac version, you can quickly record something and it'll instantaneously get you the link, which you can send on. And I really like that. And it's actually one of the faster ones out there from the ones that I've used so far. far. So number five is Loom. Now Loom has been on the market for some time now. It's my go-to choice for screen recording and sending something over. When I'm trying to explain something in the email and I don't necessarily want to jump in a call, Loom is the tool that I go to use. I record something, whether that's me webcam or me screen recording, showing them how to use a specific feature, and I send it on. And it's really nice because you can see, for example, when somebody views it, when somebody replies, or when somebody comments on a specific timestamp as well. They have some great team abilities for creating libraries with your fonts too, which is really nice, a nice addition for sure. Next up is ClickUp. Now, ClickUp does have some native recording abilities and it's something worth checking out. But I wanted to mention it because it's one of those applications that does have a lot of templates that sort of promote and have that ecosystem of remote work in it. And as you can imagine, they are cashing in on that market. It's a big market, remote work at the moment. So it's definitely worth checking out ClickUp. We've got a brand new channel called Keep Productive with ClickUp if you did want to learn more about new ClickUp updates. The final application is Droplr. And it is an application that has been around for a little bit of time now. Now, it's very similar to the likes of CloudApp and the likes of Loom, allowing you to share, create, and record anything on your screen or video. But the one that I probably would go for above those two is probably Loom or CloudApp or even Yak, just because I have experience using it, but not as much as those others. So folks, hopefully this was useful. I can see all of you just cancelling every meeting after this and having nothing in your calendar. It's really worth having a look at whether you can convert meetings into short Looms or maybe even things like that. So definitely something to check out for the future. Anyway, folks, a big, big thank you. Make sure to subscribe down there. It'd be great to have you here in the Keep Productive community. And if you did enjoy this video, please do thumbs up. And of course, if you found any value from any of these apps, comment below or share your experience if you're already using one. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you soon.